Sri Narain Das Gupta.
Thank you, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak on this Chit Funds Amendment Bill. Sir, I just rise to support this bill with few suggestions to the Honorable Minister. And I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister the two technical amendments which needs immediately in this. Sir, in this Chit Funds Act 1982, this Section 1 and Subsection 2, it states that it extends to the whole of India except to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. I think this Jammu and Kashmir needs to be deleted from this, from the original bills. This is the one technical. And second, sir, I will draw the attention to, through you, sir, to Section 24 of the original Act 1982, where it is mentioned about the maintenance of the accounts and balance sheet, and they have given the reference that it should be audited by the auditors who is eligible under the Companies Act 1956. Sir, you will agree, because you are Minister for the Corporate Affairs, that now the Company Act 1956 does not survive. As such, it should be substituted by the Companies Act 2013. These are the two small needs. These are the needs in the original Act itself. And with this, sir, I would like to just refer to suggestions. That, sir, you have taken a decision to extend the aggregate chit fund from 1 lakh to 3 lakhs and 6 lakhs to 8 lakhs. I agree with this, but only my suggestion is if it can be left to the discretion of the states, because it differs from state to state, this. And along with this, as you said, because we have increased it because of the inflation which has taken place over the years. And keeping, making a reference to this, you have increased the commission from 5 to 7. I think that does not go with the inflation. If you increase the aggregate amount of here, it will automatically take the commission for the this foreman 5%, I think, if you think so, that it can be restricted to 5%, sir. Then, sir, there is a one section, Section 2B. There is mention that, sir, that it reads is, everyone shall subscribe to certain amount of money within bracket or to certain quantity of grain. My submission, why it is restricted to grain, sir? Can be this grain can be replaced by the word certain sum in kind? Because why it is only restricted to grain? If you are giving the benefit of to make a subscription in kinds, then it should be written here to some in kind. And one thing I would like to again draw attention of Section 24, where it is prescribed for the audit. And sir, this chit fund company, because audit is all right, it should be done. But this audit, as per this provision, only the it will certify the financial statement. Because this is a technical subject, number of compliances are required. Even under Income Tax Act, there are number of provisions where our separate audit report are required other than the report on the financial statement. So my submission is, here also, if we can mention that the audit done as per Companies Act and on the format prescribed, that rules will take care of that. And that matter can be referred to our Institute of Chartered Accountant. They may come out with a format of the audit, especially for this chit fund. With these suggestions, sir, that I fully support the bill. Thank you very much, sir, for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, Narain Das Gupta ji.